There are two proteins involved. One is cadherin 23, another is protocadherin 15. But those proteins are pretty big proteins. And there is some mechanotransduction happens with force. And then what they have found out is that both are interacting, but during even the interaction, one protein unfolds due to force. So unfolding is happening before even the unbinding of that protein, which is quite intriguing from the perspective of hearing, because I also work almost in the same field. So that has given me new insight into the topic.
There were some different methodologies that I thought about incorporating into my work, sort of analysis-wise. I'm interested in analysis and maybe applying it using Markov state models to my research. So I learned some different techniques and some of the drawbacks with using it as it stands right now, and some different ways of incorporating different levels of analysis and different factors into that.
There was an excellent session on Saturday evening on cryo-electron microscopy, and I was very pleased to see some new results showing applications of novel methods could greatly speed up image processing in cryo-EM, so this should have a very big impact in the near future.
That's the fact that the analysis that people are doing at most and more at the cellular level or even at the level of an organ, and these analyses are more and more quantitative, like for example using a mass spectrometry cross-link method, or also they are doing a molecular dynamic simulation, or not exactly molecular, but simulation of what's going on at the whole bacteria or in the whole or in the virus or things like that.
The coolest thing that I've learned at this year's meeting, this is my first time being here. I'm an undergraduate, and it's just incredible how diverse the research interests are here, as well as the people. You have people from every corner of the globe here doing research and computation, in imaging, in plenty of other disciplines that I've honestly never seen a professional present in before.
Thank you for watching. And if you want to watch more from the Biophysical Society meeting, check out some of our other videos. And don't forget to subscribe.